Panameño, 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 vida mía. Yo quiero que tú me lleves a tumbo de la alegría. Yo quiero.
This project about Panama, it's a way of honoring Black Panamanians. It's a way of highlighting their contributions in this country. It's a way of telling the story to the next generation. And I just think it's important to do that. You know, we're an isthmus, as my father would say. You know, there's water on either side, but it's connected also by land. And it's a very small place that is so significant. And I've gained so much from it. I've received so much from it that I think it's important that I just take a moment and talk about my people and where we come from.
Great-grandfather Louis Arthur was born on the island of Barbados. His wife Hilda came from Jamaica. My understanding is they met in Panama. I had the good fortune of getting to spend a decent amount of time with my great-grandfather. And I remember hearing stories about the construction of the canal. And he talked about the silver roll and the gold rolls, and how black people were paid in silver and the Americans were paid in gold, and they had their separate commissaries and stores and things of that nature. In Barbados, he hadn't experienced that very direct racism that the Americans brought to Panama in the building of the canal. And at some point, he had enough of this one particular supervisor belittling him over a period of time. And the legend in the family is that one day, he had enough and took an axe handle and beat the guy up. And of course, he never worked another day in the canal. But that sense of pride that he had within himself was something that I clearly remember him imparting to me in the times that we spent together there in Panama.
Yeah, I mean, I'm Destino Johnson from Colón.
No, that's a big deal. That's a big thing. Tell me about being born in Panama.
It was amazing. Suddenly I find myself, you know, playing in this backyard, and it happened to be a city in a canal zone, which was called Silver City at that time. The first thing I remember hearing, I was about 3 or 4 years old, and I was playing in the backyard in the dirty. So yeah. Silver City was America, Middle America, West Indian America. It was like an apartheid, a black city in the canal zone of Panama. All West Indian mixture from all the islands. Within the community in Silver City, there were differences because some people claimed they were from a big island and another person was from a little island and stuff like that. But I grew up in Silver City in the beginning until I was age 7. Then all of a sudden, my parents uprooted us and decided we had to move to Colón back. Because first they started in Colón when I was about 2 months, three years, and then moved to the city. But they had to go back to Colón. And because the then president of Panama decreed that anybody who was born in Panama and did not speak Spanish or had an English surname, had to leave the country or learn the language. Now, here I was, born in a Latin American country and didn't know a word in Spanish at age 7. All they spoke around me in the Silver City was the English, the West Indian, I call it Calypso English, based on our accent, and it's Calypso. That's why we speak different. Our accent is musical. You call it West Indian, Jamaican, Trinidadian, better, Barbadian in particular. I had Jamaican and Barbadian in me, so our English was Calypso English.
My parents then, pretty much what was left for them was to get a job on the canal zone with the American government. So we knew that what we were doing and our legacy was that of building up Panama, of building that country. But we were still considered, we were just West Indians or children of West Indians. And Caribbean, you're hail from the Caribbean. Well, if you grew up on the canal zone, you may not be as aware of the original sacrifice. If you grow up in Panama City, you probably wanted to distance yourself from that kind of pain, knowing that you, your parents, your ancestors did so much, and you get no credit. So I understand when Ruben is talking about his grandfather being a West Indian man, gave his life blood to build that country, and still was never a full citizen. Folks mix up ethnicity with race. That's one of the issues that I do have. I cannot be anything but black. So I am not Latina. Though ethnicity and culture are closer tied than ethnicity, culture, and race. But I cannot be a Latina. When they talk about a Latina or a Latinx, they're not talking about me. Even though I speak Spanish, I read Spanish, I do everything in Spanish, and they who look Latin don't. What does that mean? That means that Ukrainians, Russians, British, nobody else, nobody anymore is just white, Indian, Chinese, Asian. Nobody is just anything anymore. And that's what that song is all about. We're not just anything anymore, but we're only just human beings. And when you're 17 and you're 18 and you're in love, you're not being concerned about what you look like. You're just talking pure, unadulterated, raw feelings, emotions. So where you direct it is different now because you don't have the barriers that we had. So when I see all of these mixtures going on there, I'm just about as happy as can be saying to myself, I wonder what they're saying down south. What is going on in Florida? What is happening in Texas? My, they can't stop that wave. And we used to call it the browning of America. The whole world is getting brown. And that's why my name is Brown.
You want to know what's a melting pot? Panama was really, quote unquote, a melting pot. Because we had a convergence of Spaniards, Spanish culture in Colón, Panama. Then we had the Americans who made Panama what made Panama a country. American culture. I mean, when I say American Southern, well, Louisiana was the jurisdictional American state that governed the canal zone. So we had Southern culture in the canals in Panama. And then we had the Latin American culture. The West Indian culture. So we had West Indian, American, and Latino mixed in one.
El café ya no son menos.